tonight, Lewis, drive around in the Jukes, and we battle it out on our new test track that we'll show you later in the program.
This is our new test track. You will be getting an onboard with the one and only, the Twig. And this is our tool for the fool. It is a ballista compact. Absolute beast. It's the Twig. He's very shy, but here he is, an onboard camera with Twig. He is going to take us a lap around our new test track. 3, 2, 1, go. Oh, he goes early in the turn one. Very nice. Lay on the brakes there. The Twig has only taken this track a few times, so it's not going to be perfect his first time around. But he knows where to go. Through, across, camera, lay on the brakes. Very nice there from the Twig. Cut that corner a little bit. Like turn 8 in Turkey or Abu Dhabi, Baku, Sochi, you know. Then down to the two final straights. And it's over the line. Great effort from the Twig there. This is the Twig, and this is our test car for our fool in the cheap two. Twig will be testing vehicles every week, every episode. Different cars, supercars, muscle cars, everything around the test track. So stay tuned for that. I hope you enjoyed our new test track, boys. How do you find the test track?
It's alright. Yeah, it's good. I'm enjoying it.
It's a bit hard to drive on when John's crashing into us, or Ali's trying to put a car through my windscreen. But other than that, it's pretty good, isn't it? Anyways, we will be showing you our new addition to the show in a second. The Twig. And later on, we will be having a race around there in our new cars, so stay tuned for that. This is the Imponte Jukes, the famous car from the movie Jukes of Hazzard in the early 2000s. Okay, so maybe it's not the exact same car, but still. Today, I am going to be testing whether it truly is capable of all the stunts the boys did in the movies, such as jumping bridges, jumping water logs, and just having a good time off-road. So yeah, let's go. Later then. Was sent up north to the sunny town of Palito Bay to do the next part of filming to show off how the Jukes of Hazzard car can do. He didn't seem to be too happy about it though. I can't believe they made me come up here. I'm not getting out of the fucking car, it's bloody freezing outside. Are you joking me? Alright, fine. Well, I'll be showing you why the Jukes of Hazzard Jukes is so great. The one I bought was the Highway Reaper, the Duke version. Comes with 150 more horsepower than the average one. And yes, let's go. It's generally just a nice car to have. It is an absolute beast for doing things like this. I was 110 in no time at all. Absolute beast of a car. But that's not what the Dukes is all about. It's about its agileness to get to places. Crooked places, whatever. Leading on to our next challenge up ahead to see how well the Dukes can perform in certain areas. Honestly, I have so much love for this car. It's just got so much history. It handles like a beast even on this dirt track. I can just sit happily at 80 miles an hour and not worry. Unless that happens. But leading on, it's time to test. That was easy for the Jukes. Easy. Can't believe that made that easy. Woohoo! This car is awesome. Yeah, boy. Eh? What do you mean I need to go and do another challenge? You already know that the Dukes is freaking amazing. You're going up. What the hell? Oh my. Lewis just received intel saying that he needs to go do a challenge on top of Mount Chiliad in a hill climb all the way to the top to showcase how well the Dukes really is. He wasn't too happy again. Mate, I don't see why I need to do this. This is a dangerous, stupid task. It's literally nighttime, man. I'm gonna die. But anything for the views, boys. Alright. Countdown from 10, starting now. Oh my god. Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! Oh yes. I've actually grown on this now. I'm quite excited for this one. Oh yes, on you go, sunshine. Keep left foot pin to the floor. Oh my god. Speed and power. Pray for me. Why didn't they get John doing this? Oh wait, good point. Good point. I just thought of it in my head. Go on, little charger. Go on. The Dukes is insane. They're still in retail in the market right now. Honestly, 30, 40 odd years old, but still, you need this car to do something good with your life, boys. The traction I'm getting from these literally small ass tires is insane. How are we doing for damage? I don't think we're too bad. I don't think we're doing too bad. Woohoo! Yes. Handbrake. Jukes, come on, we're so close to the finish line. Ah, this'll do. Yellow. You will now have to find a way down from the mountain without using proper trails. Good luck. Beep. Are you joking me? Oh my! Why did I? What? I should just quit this show now. Why? But this is dangerous, guys. This is dangerous. Here we go. Anyways, oh my God! Don't die on me now, little jukes. These producers are stupid, man. Yep, you heard me. Stupid! At least this handy stunt roll cage is here to stop me from hurting myself too badly. Oh no, oh no, oh no! Okay, that was just the bonnet. We're good. Shit, no. We're not good. Stay out of the tree. Whoa. Okay. Ow. Oh dear. Woohoo! Come on, little jukes. Ow. The car was indeed rebuilt and made for the next challenge. To test whether the Jukes can do this. Honestly, I'd be lying if I said I wasn't nervous about this one. But the boys got away with it in the movie. Well, maybe a bit shorter jumps, but still. Don't let me down now, Jukes. Go! And on that bottle top, back to the studio. Go.
So how many cars did you destroy while filming this?
Okay, 3 or 4, but still. Up next, we have our big new race between us three boys, who you've probably been missing throughout the program. But here we go, the big race with our brand new cars on the new test track and on the big straight. So hope you enjoy this one, guys. 3, 2, 1. Good night.
Good night.
Yeah, bunch of blacks.